Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will draw a circuit in Proteus Professional. I will simulate CD4015 or MC14015 IC in this Proteus Professional. When we want to place a component from the library, we can just hit the P button from the keyboard and we will reach here. Here is CD400 series. Come here, CD4015. Open, click here and place it. CD4015, it is dual 4-stage counter, serial input and parallel output. We will place the both sections here, A and B. It have data input, clock input and reset input. The working condition of this IC that reset pin must be low. When it is connected to ground, data available at D pin, because it is using D flip-flop circuit, so data present at D will be shifted to the output side when the clock will change. When the clock input, clock pulse will arrive, it will shuffle this data to the first pin, Q0 output, then Q1, Q2, Q3. So it is one stage. The second stage is here. We can pick component from here, LED. Okay, we will bring one LED and I will place a resistor 1 kilo ohm, MIN 1 kilo ohm resistor, rotate it, jumper it. So this is one set. We will block copy. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, because it have 8 outputs. Pin number 16 is VDD supply, so here VDD pin is hidden. The supply pins here are hidden. We will connect first LED to pin number 5, 2, 5, 4, 3 and 10, and we will bring ground from here. Pin number 8 is also ground pin, so 8 and 16 pin are not shown here. So one stage is ready now. Pin number 7 I will connect to power VDD here, and pin number 6 we will connect. For this time, I will connect to ground and then we will change it to make an auto reset. So this is our first stage. Same way, I will make connections for the second side. And I will bring this block here. I will inject a clock signal here. From here, from the devices, I will set here pulse. I will give a pulse here. We will set to pulsed high voltage 5 volts, pulse width 50% and frequency is 1 hertz. Okay. Now we completed the conditions here. That pin number 6 is ground, pin 7 is VDD, and here we connected 1 hertz signal, 1 hertz 5 volt signal, pulse. Let's simulate it. You can see first LED on, second LED on, third on, fourth on. This time it stopped here and the second section is still off. So let's bring it closer to this one. Now what we need to do, we need clock input at pin number 1. Now we will apply the same clock pulse to pin number 1 and we will connect this reset to pin number 6. 14 and 6 are connected together and grounded, And now the second condition. To activate the second stage, we need to connect pin number 15 to this pin number 10. So when pin number 10 will high, at that time the next clock pulse, because this section is also receiving clock pulse, but it will not work because the data here is low. At each clock pulse the output will low. But now we will connect this pin to pin number 10. So when the last LED will turn on, it will have high voltage, it will have logic high, that will cause to enable this section. When pin number 10 is high, this high signal will reach to data input pin number 15. So this IC will also start to write high signal at the output side. Let's power it on, simulate it. First LED on, second on, third on, fourth on, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. At eighth LED, this IC will stop. Now to reset this IC, to start again from 00, we need a high signal at pin number 14 just for a while. So that high pulse will reset this IC. Let's remove this ground from reset pin and we will make a jumper. We will connect the last output of this IC to pin number 14 and 2 in normal conditions. Pin number 2 is low. When it will high? When it will receive high signal at the last pin. In the last pulse, when it will receive high signal, it will reset. So the IC will start loop back. Let's apply signal. Simulate. Now high. Second stage is working now. When this will start, now reset. So we will drive 7 LEDs. The 8th LED, that is Q3 output of the second stage, it will cause to reset the IC. Let me increase the speed of this signal, for example 5 hertz, so it will move fastly. Yes, so in this situation we can remove this last LED, so it will work in this way. Pin number 7 we will connect to positive. Pin 9 and 1 we will connect to clock signal, any clock signal, either it is manual clock or automatic clock. And pin 6 and 14 we will connect it together and we will connect to pin number 2. At any output stage we can make a reset. If we will loop this pin number 10 to pin number 6, so this IC will turn on just only these 3 LEDs. At pin number 10, the 4th output will cause to reset, so these 3 LEDs will work. In our next session we will design this circuit practically and we will see its different features. I hope this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.